I'm taking the first steps to building a gas-fired kiln. And the first step, of course, is collecting bricks. So that's what we're going to do today. We already collected some of them, as you can see here. We have this pile of bricks here, and we're going to collect some more now. This is where I got all the stone from. There used to be a small wood-fired kiln here, and the people living here are moving, so I was lucky enough to get all the stones, except I had to take it all apart and get it home to my own place, which is just 2 minutes drive from here, so it was quite easy. So we just finished. This is the last part of it. And we're taking it all home and stacking it up there. And then later, maybe this year, maybe next year, we'll build a kiln. It's kind of a big project, so it won't be done in a few months. We're done. We moved just about 600 of these high-fired bricks, a little bit of some normal bricks, and we also have all these that are half bricks and quarter bricks and some plates and stuff. And yeah, well, as you can see, this pile of bricks almost have the size of a kiln. And of course, I'm not gonna have it solid like that. It's gonna be a hole in the middle. So I think there should be enough for the kind of kiln that I wanna build. I wanna build it big enough to fire some of my bigger pots. Right now I have an electric kiln and I have some my pit fire and my rago kilns, and they can take up to about 65 centimeters. But I would like to be able to produce bigger pots than that. Now, I'm expecting the gas kiln to be maybe 1 meter, 120, 130, something like that, so I can make a little bit above 1 meter pots. And of course, I can also do bisque firing in the gas-fired kiln. But the primary reason for the gas-fired kiln is so I can fire in reduction. I'll get back to that. But basically with reduction fire, you can create some colors that are impossible to get if you fire an oxidation. So very nice celadon glazes, red glazes and stuff like that. But now that I build it, or when eventually I will build it, I will make it big enough to have bigger pots. If we take a closer look at these stones, these are high fire bricks. So these are not normal bricks. You can't use normal bricks if you want to build a kiln because it's simply going to melt. These ones are made for, I think they can go up to 1350 degrees centigrade. So that should be enough for even cone 11. So we need something like that. I have here 600 bricks, which is, I think, almost enough for the kiln that I want to build. I'm looking now at different constructions. I picked up a couple of books. One book in particular that I want to recommend is Fred Olson's book, the Kiln book or something. I will show you a link to that. It's known to be one of the best kiln building books. I also have another one that I will put a link to it. And these two books will help me build. I'm going to build a kiln with a flat roof, and most of the kilns that you see have this arch, which looks really beautiful, but there's been a lot of testing done, and actually a flat roof fires just as well, and it's much easier to build it. Building an arch requires some skills that I just don't have, so I'm not going to go that way. Another thing that's difficult when you want to build a kiln is the door. But you don't actually need a door. I'm going to do the same thing that you do in a wood-fired kiln and just leave an open hole and have the bricks ready and then put in bricks when I fire it. So it's going to be a manual door, so to speak. I also have a number of of half bricks, bricks that have been cut up. And the thing is, with these kind of bricks, normally with a normal brick, you can just keep it in your hand and then you hammer it, and it will split apart. But these bricks don't do that. They are so heavy, and actually you can feel it there, about twice the weight of a normal brick. So you can't do that. You actually need to grind it something in it, and then you can break it up. It's much more difficult. So I already have these because, as I said, I took it down from another kiln, so I have all these half stones, and I need that to create the actual kiln. I also have some plates here that I can use for the inside. So all in all, I have everything I need. I must admit that I'm still not 100% sure where to put this gas kiln in my garden. And also, if I will build that as the first thing, because the bricks, the fire bricks that I got, could also potentially be used to build another pit fire kiln. I already have a barrel pit fire and a couple of Raku kilns and an electric kiln, but sometimes I do bigger things than what can fit into the barrel kiln, a pit fire kiln. So I may want to build a bigger pit fire. It's a much easier job because basically it's just a box and the lid is just a piece of metal. So it's very easy to build that. I can just stack the stones and I can use these stones for that. But of course my big dream is to build that perfect gas kiln. So my garden is in a residential area. So there is neighbors on both sides. On one side, they're a little further away than on the other side. They're very friendly. And so I hope I won't run into too many problems with a gas kiln. Now, with the gas kiln, of course, it doesn't produce that much pollution or noise or smoke or anything. Actually, it shouldn't produce any smoke. It's just like a barbecue grill. It's just gas burning, and there will be some heat, but there won't be any severe smoke or soot or anything like that. So it shouldn't really affect my neighbors. But again, I still want to place it where it functions well, and where, if there should be any problems with neighbors, it's minimized as much as possible. So let's take a look around the garden and see where it potentially could be. My first and probably preferred option for where to build the gas-fired kiln would be here. Right now there's this old playhouse, but my kids are old now, so not that old, but they're 15 and 18, so they don't play in this house anymore. Also, it have seen better days, so it needed a fix-up anyway. And the good thing is that it already have laid a more or less even surface of bricks or tiles down there. So it would be relatively easy, I think, to remove this and then start from scratch there. And also, as you can probably see here, there's quite a high fence to my neighbor, and they're very friendly and there won't be any problems. Also, I will be building, I don't have that now, I will be building a carport, I think it's called, for my car. It's down there by the end or right now, but I will build it here. And by the end of that, there will be a small shed for tools and stuff, and I could actually have whatever tools I need for my kiln. So that would actually be a very good place. The only downside of having it here is that it's not directly located to where I usually do my ceramics. I do that inside in the house, but I also have this area in the other end of the garden where I have my pit fire barrel I was just talking about. Down here is a couple of my Raku kilns, and in here is my workshop, outdoor part of it, where I have my storage of all the chemicals and stuff, and my compressor for spray painting glazes, and of course this is also where I have my electric kiln. So it would actually to some degree be nicer to have it closer to this area, also because down here if you move down this stair, you're going to get into my basement, and this is where I have my drying sheds, and so a lot of the pottery that I will be firing will be there. So I'm thinking that might be better. And also, if you look out here, this area, let me just turn the camera, this area will, right now it's stone, but there will eventually be some tiles or something here. It will be like a working area for me with the Raku kilns and the pitfire kiln. And as you see, at least in the summertime, it's, let me turn it the other way. There's houses back there, but there's also lots of trees here that will kind of cover up things a little bit. So I'm also thinking, well, maybe I should put it here, maybe next to the fence up to the pottery, or maybe on the other side. I'm not sure about that. I don't want to put it too close to my my chickens. We also have chickens in the garden. Right now, I think they're hiding inside because we are in the middle of a heat wave in Denmark, which some of you may laugh about because it's only 30, 35 degrees, but it's pretty hot for Denmark. So I think they're hiding in a little room in there. Anyway, I don't want to put it too close to the chickens because they are sort of scared animals and I don't want to do anything to upset them. Also, I do have space in the rest of the garden. I need to mow that lawn. I know. Anyway, I could put it in the end of the garden or in the corner over here, but again, that's going to be too far away from where I have my pottery. And also, this part of the garden, let me bend it down. This part of the garden is where we kind of enjoy ourselves. We have the patio up there, and we have like an area under the cherry tree. And so, I don't want to, I mean, it's still a garden that I'm going to use for my everyday life and my family and stuff. So I want to combine it with the workspace and stuff. But I'm thinking that it's probably going to be down there by the old playhouse. Besides the final decision on the location and, of course, the design of the kiln, there's still a few different designs that I'm looking at. There's still a few more considerations to make. I still need to figure out exactly what burners to use. I'm probably going to go with wood burners or what are they called? They're called. I will put a link in there. There's an American company that are well known to do these high-powered burners, and know to drill them with the right holes and stuff and all that. A little more expensive than the cheapest ones you can get, but they're very high quality. And still, considering the fact that I got all these stones for free, I'm ready to spend a few hundred dollars on the right burners. Also need to decide on the size. So there's still a few more steps. This kiln is not going to be finished within the next few weeks or even the next few months. It's going to take more time. But I will keep posting about the progress I make, and also if I build a larger pitfire kiln before I go into the gas-fired kiln, I will show you that as well. And of course, when I start building it and all the drawings and considerations, I will share with you. So please subscribe to this channel, share, like, whatever. If you have any comments or any good suggestions, please add a note down there in the comment field. And I hope to see you soon again.